So today we celebrate the very foundation of our faith, the Eucharist, Jesus Christ. It is a special solemnity because without the Eucharist, you can't talk about the church. We can't talk about Christianity even, because the Eucharist is Jesus. And so when we celebrate the body and blood of Christ, we are actually celebrating the real and the true presence of Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. When we look at the Eucharist, we are actually looking at Jesus. I remember one time in some parish, I gave somebody a particle of the Eucharist when they came to receive. Then they complained after Mass. They came to the sacrist. But you gave me a small Eucharist. The insinuation was that I gave that person a part of Jesus. They complained. Others were receiving the whole Eucharist. But you just gave me this small thing. Jesus is really and truly present in every particle of the Eucharist. It doesn't matter the size. Every particle of the Eucharist. And that is why when we come to receive the Eucharist and we consume the bigger Eucharist that we are given, those small particles that you can hardly see that remain in your palm, those are supposed to be consumed as well, because they are Jesus Christ. Jesus is present in them just as he is present in the bigger Eucharist that you consumed. Truly and really present. What is the Eucharist? The Eucharist, of course, is Jesus Christ himself. But the Eucharist is also a meal, a banquet. A banquet that God always prepares for his believing community, for his people, for you and I. A banquet to which everybody is invited, regardless of race, tribe, and whatever else. To this meal, we are all invited. And when we come and we feed from the same table, this Eucharist turns us from being strangers to one another to being brothers and sisters in Christ. It has the unifying character. So we become one. We become one family. And when we become one family, so we become a Eucharistic community. And when we become a Eucharistic community, in this community, there should be peace, there should be love. Nobody should lack anything because everybody is supposed to be taking care of everybody else. And that is what we become as a community, as a church. And that is what we are supposed to be. The Eucharist is not just a banquet or a meal. It is also sacrifice. It is sacrifice. It is Jesus Christ offering himself for you and I. It is Jesus Christ being offered, and the one that is offering that sacrifice is Jesus Christ himself through the action of the priest who acts in persona Christi, in the person of Christ himself. This is the mystery of the Eucharist. Jesus offering himself for you and I. We can't talk about ourselves as a community, as a church, without the Eucharist. Because the Eucharist is everything. It is the summit of our Christian life. Now, the Eucharist is not like Panadol or like any other medicine that you take that begins to work automatically. The Eucharist has to be received in faith and with faith. Sometimes we receive the Eucharist because it is something that we always do when we come to Mass. But the Eucharist should be received with faith because it is not magic. It is not something mechanical. If you don't understand the meaning of what you're receiving, it actually doesn't have any meaning to you at all. We first of all understand and appreciate the significance of what we are receiving. And then we put ourselves in the mood that is required for the reception of the Eucharist, and then we come forward and we receive that. Our Christian life is a pilgrimage. All of us are pilgrims, and we are coming from God and going back to God. Now, this pilgrimage is not an easy one. Sometimes we meet experiences that weigh us down. Sometimes we are tired of walking. We want to rest. Sometimes we don't, we even lose focus of where we are going. We lose focus of God. And we don't understand our Christian life even anymore. The Eucharist, Jesus Christ, is the food that gives us strength. The strength we need to continue walking regardless of what we meet on this journey. In Bemba, there's what we call impao. Impao is the food that you carry when you are on a long journey. I don't know if people still carry impao nowadays. But many years ago, when some of us were born many, many years ago, people used to carry impao. When you know you're going to be on a long journey, you're going to prepare food from home. Maybe it is a chicken that you prepare nicely or anything. You prepare that and then you wrap it nicely, you put it in your bag. As you are on that journey and you reach a certain point where you feel you need to eat something, otherwise you're going to be weak, you bring out that food and you start to eat. The purpose of that food is to give you strength to reach your destination. Now, when I say many, many years ago, I'm talking about those ages when people never used to board buses, Marco Polo and everything else. When people used to walk from Lusaka to Chongwe, from Chongwe to Luangwa, when they used to walk long, long distances, they needed impao, they needed that food so that they have the strength they need for them to reach the destination. Our destination on this pilgrimage is God, and we are walking towards Him. Now, this walk is not an easy one. We need food that is going to give us strength for us, first of all, not to lose focus of where we are going, but also for us to have the strength we need to reach that destination. And for us, that food is Jesus. It is Christ. Jesus, every time we meet at Mass, feeds us with Himself so that we may have this energy we need for us to reach our destination. Let us pray that what we become as a believing community, as a Eucharistic community, may indeed be seen in concrete life. What do we become? We become a community of love. We become a community that is sanctified by the presence of Christ Himself. And so in this community, nobody is supposed to lack anything, because everybody is supposed to be looking after everybody else. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. Amen.